Good morning. Welcome back to my channel. Today, it is 7:10 and we are embarking on a concert tour de France with the City of Belfast Youth Orchestra. I used the phrase Chateau de Carrickfergus 12 times in my French orals this summer.
Really?
Innocence,
I keep a check. She was a bad, bad, nevertheless. Calling it quiz now, baby, I'm a wreck. Crash at my place.
Whatever floats your boat.
Stop, child.
Cake. Bring back pints.
Yeah!
Right, lads, what's a crack? We're on the stand line. We're like somewhere in the Irish Sea. It's a bit bumpy, and I'm joined with Matty. How are you doing, Matty?
I'm doing good today, Ed.
How are you finding this ferry?
Not great, to be fair.
Is it cake?
It is cake.
Matthew, have you visited the shops on board the ferry? Are they expensive?
I have. They are extremely overpriced.
Do you believe that €13 for two bags of Haribos is a bit of a scam?
I believe that is absolutely criminal.
Criminal, folks. To my right, I'm joined by Hugo Riley Stewart. Hugo, how are you?
Wonderful.
Hugo, it's not the first time you've been interviewed on the channel. Are you glad to be interviewed again today?
Not as nervous as last time.
He said in the last interview that he was a good role model for the people in the youth orchestra to follow. Is it good for the youngest person in the orchestra, Matthew? Do you feel that you're a good role model for him?
I'd like to think so.
I had many role models to look up to when I was the youngest, such as...
Sorry, lots of bit of turbulence here.
Turbulence such as, you know, the greats such as Harvey Jones, Ethan Hayward and all that.
Johnny Hayward?
Johnny Hayward was still a youth.
Well, I was a youth.
Were you like,
I was a youth,
yeah.
He would have been, what, like 15, 16 when I joined, so... But he's turned into a wonderful role model, like, you know.
Bring back pints.
Now, Matthew, do you think Hugo is a good leader to look up to and to practice your instrument to realise where you could be one day?
I would fully agree with everything that you just said there. And yeah, Hugo Riley Stewart is an amazing leader.
Hugo Riley Stewart's cake.
What is this cake? Where's cake?
On the other side of the table, we have the Three Musketeers, as they're known. We have Theo Hayward.
Theodore Patrick Hayward.
We have Derv LeCoggins, and we have Evie Mills. Theo, how are you?
Fantastic today, Edward. Mate, yourself?
I'm not too bad. Derv, how are we?
I'm great, thanks, Ed. How are you?
I'm good. Evie, how are you?
All right, yeah.
Right, where are you from, lads?
From the mighty BT40 and the game.
Yep. Derv, where are you from?
From Dundalk, in Louth.
County Louth, represent. Evie, what about you?
I'm from Bangor.
Yep. Theo, what does the CBSM mean to you, and how has it benefited your instrumental value?
It's been very special for me, like, so it's just been gas crack at the same time.
Fair play to you. Dervla, we all know that you make a very big effort to come from County Louth every weekend to the City of Belfast Youth Orchestra. Why do you do it?
Well, there's not much music in Dundalk, so I had to choose between Dublin and Belfast, and there's just such great music available in Belfast, and I just prefer the people in Belfast, so I decided to make the journey up.
Fair play to you, Dervla. Cake, bring back pints.
Johnny, what are your thoughts on Mead Mondays?
Mead Mondays, most important day of the week, mate. Nothing better than finishing your day with a pint of mead. You think I'm joking? I'm dead serious.
And opinions on Meady Munters?
Is that just a synonym for Theodore Patrick Hayward?
Speaking of Theodore Patrick Hayward, What are your opinions on the viola being the worst orchestral instrument invented?
That seems slightly biased. Montgomery, not gonna lie, mate.
My name isn't Montgomery, it's Cormac. Yeah, that's all for this interview. Cake.
Is it your birthday?
Yeah.
What age are you, son?
I'm 18.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Cake! Master Andrew Sayers, how are you?
Fantastic, how are you?
I'm not doing too bad. Andrew, how are we finding the experience on the boat today?
A bit seasick I'm feeling, but you know, I'll be alright.
Have you had a seasick pill?
No, I just built different milk. I don't know.
He is like that.
Twelve sleepless hours later.
Breakfast on the ferry, 7.5 out of 10. Much better than the fish and chips last night. And it wasn't that bad of a price.
Hello.
Dara, you were causing a bit of a ruckus last night, weren't you?
Yeah. Shenanigans.
Yeah. People were trying to sleep on vomit. By the way, we do have a voice crack counter going. Right now I'm on 25 voice cracks after about 24 hours. So just watch out for that.
Wicked, original, well, big up, our original jungle is massive.
Bonjour, je suis en France. I am in France. We're at a baker's because I need a baguette. Need to try a baguette, so we have to wait in line here. Try to take Apple Pay, gents. How are we?
Are you glad to be here?
Yeah, apart from speaking the language, but yeah.
Why?
We're trying to debate whether they speak English or not.
I think you should try a bit of French, see what happens.
I nearly spoke Icelandic by accident, but you know.
Yo, then you could say I'm from a different region of France. And then,
yeah.
Exactly.
One where they speak Icelandic?
Aye. What are we going for today, lads?
Depends what I can say. Undecided.
See, we're here for baguettes. The national bread of France. Let's turn around here. Who have we got?
Oliver.
James.
Dara.
What are we here for today, lads?
Baguette, obviously.
Baguette, of course.
Baguette, obviously.
See, it's the Ned Cut effect. Who have we got behind them? How are we?
Sophia.
Holly.
What are we here for today?
I'm just joining them on the journey.
What about you, Orla?
A pan of chocolate.
Holly, what are we?
A baguette or something.
We're going to wait here and see if they take Apple Pay, because if they don't, we're snookered because all the cash is in the bus. So, you may ask, what is the plan of action? Well, the idea is, get a baguette, then we're going to go to some sort of supermarché and get some ham, and then get some butter, and then we're all good. We have then we have food for the coach, and we can go and see the sights of Bayeux. Yo lads, I know the French are all like a bit snobbish about like being fresh and all, but is that mold? We're about to order. Bonjour. Je voudrais un pain, baguette, s'il vous plaît.
Un pain?
Oui.
Oui. Voilà. Avec ceci, c'est tout? It's okay, fini.
Oh, oui. baguette secured. Let's take a first bite. To be fair, this is pretty good. Very fresh, very nice. Nice and hard crust. Good baguette, thank you. Monte, are you enjoying that there?
Oh yeah, delicious.
Theo, do we like it? You're really tearing it up there.
It's good scram, man. It's good scram.
Johnny, what about yourself? Already finished. Me and Guilty, we're just back from the walk with the rest of the CBIO collective. We've got the new football top here. I rate it very highly. £27 off Depop. Good value for a very nice top. Guilty, what do you rate it?
I rate it like a 4 out of 10 because it's Chelsea.
This guy, see you later. Just open it. He's a smooth operator.
The bar was too expensive.
How much are pints? Bit pricey.
Yo, room turn.
Welcome to room 314.
We got the bathroom.
Yo, we're going up to the toilet though.
Don't wash.
Is that right?
Send me that part of the video. You know who I am. You know who I am.
My counter for the end of the day is 45? 46? 46? 47? Or not?
I could say that.
Bit of a harder. Still legal, like it's the best thing I've had apart from these.
What do you call those eggs?
Pan au chocolat. That's 48. Morning, gentlemen and ladies. We woke up about an hour ago. We've had a breakfast. It was alright, like, no fry, so, because we're in France, funnily enough. But apart from that, it was all good. We're going to Paris today. We're going to see the Louvre, mate.
Good morning.
I'd have made more of an effort this morning if I'd known I was going to be on camera.
Who am I here with?
Start taking a photograph like that's what.
He's already away. Who am I here with?
You're here with George.
How are we, George?
I'm living the dream, you know.
We're in France. It's a nice view, isn't it, George?
It is a lovely view.
Quite spectacular. But this is a better view right here, Mr. Sanford. Is this your first time in France, George?
No. The last time I was in France was on Super Bowl tour, like 20 years ago.
He's back again.
Back again.
First trumpets.
Finally.
It's taken some time. George, are you excited to play in such a brilliant concert hall in the next few days?
I could not be more excited. Can you not tell by my face?
Ecstatic. How are you finding these gardens themselves?
I'd like to go and see them, to be honest.
Right, so George will wrap this up here. Thank you very much. See you later. Today, I'm in the Palace of Versailles, a place that is holding the City of Belfast Youth Orchestra for the current moment in time. And today, I'm joined by Harry Douglas. Harry, how are you?
So good, mate. What's happening?
Are you enjoying the Palace of Versailles?
Yeah, it's class, isn't it?
It's a beautiful place and it's got some beautiful surroundings and local area. Harry, we're going to go on a walk. So Harry, how long have you been in the CBYO for?
So this is my third year in CBYO.
Are you excited to play Chike 4 in such good concert halls?
Amazing symphony, one of his best, personally.
He's feeling it?
Feeling it so much.
He loves it. So,
get this man out.
Few hooligans once again.
French hooligans, like.
They like French. To say, oh, bonjour.
Je m'appelle, mate.
Can you say any French?
Merci beaucoup.
Can you say, my name's Harry?
Je m'appelle Harry, mate.
Can you spell it?
H-A-R-R-Y.
Is Harry in French Ash? R-R-E?
Potentially. You tell me.
Something like that.
You're the reporter.
I am the reporter. Where's Quinn and McGurn? You like that, do you? Slightly underwhelming. Theo, are you excited to meet Mona?
Incredibly so, mate. Honestly, can't wait.
What's your favourite painting by Leonardo da Vinci?
I only know the Mona Lisa, I'm sorry.
To be fair, do you know any others?
Is that one
that one's cracker? That one's more impressive than the Mona Lisa.
I don't know who that's by, but it's cracker.
The Mona Lisa. The most underwhelming painting of all time. I do not understand the queue. Thoughts on the Mona Lisa?
It's pretty small, like.
It's a bit underwhelming.
Just soak in the atmosphere. Say magnifique.
Shush. Mona Lisa, like, what were your opinions on the Mona Lisa?
Pretty anticlimactic, actually. Not underwhelming, just, you know, it's just a painting.
Fact.
There was even some music there as well, so, yeah.
Riz!
We just got kicked out. What is this?
Literally, we were sitting in an empty exhibit. This wasn't happening.
Is that the thumbnail?
We were just whistling.
Is this thumbnail kicked out of the Louvre?
We were just whistling. Like, we were doing William Tell, and this guy kicked us out of the Louvre.
Just go back in and say, what's it like? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a sand cruise. We're on a boat, and that is the Eiffel Tower. And this is the Ed Nethercott YouTube channel. Thomas, how are you?
I'm absolutely not doing too bad. I'm not doing too bad, ladies and gentlemen.
Do you want an interview? I can speak a bit of French. Interview? Any English? Any English? Are you on France in your holidays?
Oui.
Are you enjoying it? Oh, are they French?
No, I speak some French.
Are you enjoying your holidays?
Yeah.
Where are you from?
Canada.
Canada? That's mental. Was it like a long flight?
Yeah, 10 hours.
Fair enough, fair play to you.
Where did you guys fly from? That's a long flight.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, BC Canada.
Alright, mate, how are you?
Hello.
Are you from Canada as well? Are you enjoying France? It's a busy place, isn't it?
It is.
Have you seen any pickpockets?
No.
Have you been to the Louvre?
Not inside.
No Mona Lisa, no. Are you going to go and see it?
No, we're leaving tomorrow.
What time's your flight up?
10.
That's not that bad.
We have to leave at 6.
Yeah, that's not that bad. I'm from...
That's pretty bad.
That's not that bad. See where I'm from? You wake up at that time to get the sheep. Lady.
I don't like the audience.
I know.
No, I can't have the audience.
Right, you lads, all these
lads. It has to be a surprise once it comes out.
Good afternoon. Today I'm joined by Mr. Niall Catney and Miss Neve Catney on the Eiffel Tower in Paris. I have a few questions for you today. Are we ready?
Yes, absolutely. Before we get started, I just want to say we're delighted to be here with you now. Thank you so much for asking us to come on. And I don't care what they say about you, I think you're a great lad.
Thank you, sir.
A fine trumpet player.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate that.
He's here to see a 13.
Oh! Oh! Good on, Harvey! What is your dream holiday?
Oh, Santorini.
Vegas.
Gambling? Fair enough. Has your marital bond strengthened and blossomed over the course of this tour?
It's been up and down, you know. When we were getting up the stairs there and he pulled me through, I wouldn't have made it up here.
Yes.
How has CBYO helped to kindle the flame that is your love for one another?
CBYO is our love for one another.
What he said.
What's your favourite song to listen to on a sunny day?
I'm going to go Teenage Dirtbag.
Tune.
Rock 2.
Fair play to you. Who is the funniest staff member?
I'm going to say my wife.
I was going to say me.
Self-confidence, we do love a bit of that. Hugo, your first bite of the so-called best burger in Paris. Are you excited?
You can taste the hard work behind that. So you can. Do you agree?
No.
He doesn't agree. But that's just Patrick, isn't it?
What's the best pub crawl you've ever done?
Oof, I've never been to a pub crawl.
Not even around Belfast?
You wouldn't catch me on one of those.
Fair enough. Prague. What stays in Prague stays in Prague. You like that? Right, lads, I'm going to have my first bite here. Let's give it a wallop. Very nice. Lots of sauces. Nice rare burger. 8.5 out of 10. We haven't had any other burgers, so I can't comment on whether it's the best burger in Paris, but it's fairly good. How many years in CBYO?
3.
4.
Knew that one was a controversial one.
That's it, I'm out. No more questions.
If you didn't play the violin, what would you play?
Cello.
If you didn't play the cello, what would you play?
That's a good question. The trumpet to be like mad.
See, I'm such an inspiration. What is the best instrument?
The cello.
Best instrument?
Double bass.
Thank you.
Not even a dent.
Oh, that's good.
Nah. In the bin.
For the second half of the day, I kind of forgot about this. We had a concert in the church. It was alright. Like, tonight's concert was, it was okay. Ups and downs. We move on. Two concerts in Provence. The heat was absolutely terrible. Like, and the concert in Provence is going to be so much hotter. The plan of action. Tomorrow morning, we will wake up at about 5:45 to get ready for the day ahead. We will go down for breakfast at 6:25. We'll have all of our bags packed before we leave for breakfast. Then, after breakfast, we will hop on a coach where we'll go to the train station. Then, from the train station, we get on a train and we get the TGV down to Provence. Provence? Funky. Then after that, we're in Provence. Two more concerts.
The beach.
Beach. Night, night. Peace out. I'll see you in the morning then. Bali!
Bali!
Fuck!